Hi, I'm Gavin, and these are the Coffee Conspiracies. On 6 August 2011, my wife and I were in London, returning from Iron Maiden's last concert of their Final Frontier tour. As thousands of people happily headed home, thousands more were out in the streets rioting and setting fire to buildings and cars. One of the awful and iconic moments of those days was of the arson attack on the House of Reeves furniture store in Croydon. That became my impression of South London. Angry, deprived, self-destructive. Except, perhaps I was wrong. It is also a fast-growing, rapidly developing city within the London metropole. The first specialty coffee shops are opening, and there is a fantastic street food and a wonderful mix of vibey markets and peaceful parks. In this episode of Coffee Conspiracies, I explored Croydon to discover whether you should start your growth hacking office there. The office I looked at is on the fourth floor of this building in Catherine Street. It's opposite the Croydon Town Hall and shares space with the Fairfield School of Business. It's around the corner from the high street, including its pedestrianised mall, and exceptionally convenient to just about everything the city has to offer. I even spotted the tragic sight of a Blacks in its natural habitat of closing down. The office is advertised as about £300 per square metre, and you can even rent space ranging from 10 to 250 square metres. For about 160 square metres, you'd be looking at £50,000 a year, considerably more than double the current rated value you see listed in our Pikaya property reports. Perhaps as an indicator of the demand for office space here, Croydon also has average office rentals being quite a bit higher than average retail rentals. This office is one of those serviced places aimed at small startups. In this, you're paying not only for the central location and easy access to London, but also for the additional facilities provided. This space will house about 13 people, and you'd need revenues of close to £2 million to break even. Our estimates are that a typical business of this type in Croydon would turn about £2.5 million a year. Obviously, there are no guarantees, but the money is out there. Croydon itself is a city of almost 400,000 people, and with the high average profit margins one expects so close to the centre of London. The city has a £5.25 billion investment programme, including the Westfield and Hammerson's £1.4 billion retail and leisure destination. Looking at the data, most of these statistics will be unsurprising, from the higher than average salaries to high profit margins and productivity. Office-based businesses are also responsible for just over half of business revenue in Croydon, and a similar proportion of employment. What will surprise you is the relatively high vacancy rate. Partly this is explained by Croydon being relatively less prosperous in comparison to central London. There are certainly areas of intense redevelopment, such as the recently opened box park at the station, and some lovely new buildings giving the city centre its own skyline. But there are also buildings such as these. This is Nestlé Tower. Nestlé moved out at the end of 2012, and the building has been vacant ever since. You cannot, however, rent space in it. There is a law called permitted development, which allows property owners to rapidly change the use of a property. In this case, in 2013, the landlords wanted to convert the building to residential apartments. In 2015, nothing having happened, the property was sold on for £10 million. In March 2017, nothing having continued to happen, it sold again for £60 million. So while speculators happily inflate the value and trade this lump of concrete to each other, it remains listed as a commercial building and distorts the vacancy rate. This is not unusual. One will often see these hotspots in our Pikaya maps and discover an entire building standing vacant. Sometimes they have been vacant like this for a decade. It's critical for our revenue and cost estimates to know these buildings are vacant, but it does tend to give you a false sense of economic activity. These places aren't empty for lack of business opportunity, but for lack of landlord capacity to complete their plans. So while it appears that Croydon's office space may be 26% vacant, the reality is that many tall buildings are waiting on redevelopment. And redevelopment can be really slow. One scar which still haunts Croydon is the land in front of the surviving House of Reeves building. 6 years after the horrors of the London riots, this barren spot remains as a rather sad-looking park. Where does that leave your growth hacking business? Should you invest here and in this particular office? I travel a great deal in researching these episodes, and there are two forces which tug at each other as you make these choices. If you must be near London, then you must also accept that rents and costs are going to be much higher, and you are going to struggle to find affordable accommodation nearby. In previous episodes, whether in Hull or Merthyr Tydfil, I've pointed out that you can often get rents for less than the rated value. In London, you're going to find that rents are considerably higher than these valuations. and Croydon is no exception. However, you should be able to live close to where you work, while still being a reasonably short train ride from the centre. This also means all the networking benefits of living and working in a big city. There has been a great deal of investment in Croydon since the London riots. It's a fast-changing, rapidly integrating, highly diverse city within London. I think you'll find a business there. As usual, you'll find all the links below in the commentary to this video, including a link to the Croydon Urban Edge. This is Croydon's economic development team who can help you with rental negotiations and access to finance. Now, let's go find some coffee.